actually something I really like is like fighting in environments that are like askew.
Hmm.
Like a broken skyscraper on its side.
Yeah.
In this case. That's really cool to me.
I think it's cool.
It's actually one of the reasons I wish Inversion had been a good game. It's not, but it's got... You got all these gravity powers, and sometimes you're, like, on the sides of buildings and whatnot, and it could have been cool if...
I actually don't remember Inversion being that bad. Was it?
It's not terrible! It's not terrible.
It's not
a... It's a reasonably serviceable third-person shooter. It's just not good, either. You know what I mean?
It's not a ringing endorsement.
No. I wouldn't give it a ringing... If someone wanted to be named, like, a really bad shooter, I wouldn't name Inversion.
Mm.
But it's just kind of meh. Oh! They got me.
Ugh.
Which is a shame, because the premise is cool.
So I was in GameStop the other day, actually, and you know what I realized? It's been such a long time since I've heard, like... Since I saw a game, and I'm like, I have no idea what this is. So I was shopping around in the bargain bin, and they had this game called Genji, the Last Blade or something. And it was just some, like, generic-looking samurai game. But, like, I had never heard of it.
I might have that somewhere.
I had never heard of the studio making it. I was like, what the fuck is this? And the guy behind the counter is like, I've never heard of this game. I was just so intrigued.
Did you get it?
I did not. It didn't tickle my fancy. Like, all the screenshots I saw of the game were like the same screenshot over and over, and I was like, I don't know if I want to play this. And you know what? I'm pretty sure nobody else in the area I'm living in is going to go out and swoop that up. Like, I live in a college town, so it's like if people are gonna buy games, it's gonna be Call of Duty or Battlefield, you know.
Or something that's not Genji.
Something that's not like, I don't know what this is.
Oh, you see that? That's the charge. That was the charge shot.
Right. Okay.
You see, it keeps exploding.
Yeah.
It kind of got stuck in one place. Normally, it bounces around more, but. You can see how, you know, properly deployed, the potential for havoc something like that would have.
Yeah. What's he saying?
I don't know. It's never really intelligible.
Hmm.
As far as, at least, that I can discern.
Interesting.
Yeah, all the enemy voices, it's all just...
gibberish?
Yeah, as far as I know.
That's interesting. I do wonder if there's, like, a deeper story to this game than is on the surface. I don't think there would be.
You mean, like, the story of, like, you mean in-game story?
Yeah. But, yeah, I don't think there would be, but it'd be intriguing if there was.
Like I said, pity we never got a sequel or anything. I'd enjoy seeing more of this universe.
Hmm. And you know what? I actually think this game is interesting enough for me to at least play a sequel. I don't know necessarily that I'd be like, this game is, like, game of the... I think it'd be a nice B game. And it's sad, because there aren't a whole lot of B games left. You know what I mean?
Oh, watch it. This is... Just set that off. And it's going to... Luckily, since Bulletstorm runs on Roadrunner physics...
Of course.
We are propelled into Act 5.
Well, see? Like, these last three chapters have just... been one act, like, these last three acts have been one chapter apiece.
No, they've been multiple chapters, it's just they've been going a lot faster. Like, it's weird, Act 1 is, like, longer than several of the other acts combined.
Huh. Find that strange. indeed. Pain in the ass. Everything. Yeah. I'm sure we're almost out of the woods now, though.
Monorails were running last time. I scanned what they tried. All right, come on. Yeah, monorails.
Hmm.
Monorail.
I'd actually really like to ride, one of those super quick Japanese monorails.
Oh, like those maglev trains?
Yeah. Those are cool.
Yeah.
Are you just sitting here?
I'm not sure what happened there, but maybe I was drunk when I was recording this and I nodded off.
That'd be so sad. I'm just imagining you, like, playing the game in the dark and then just kind of falling asleep and then sitting up abruptly,
jerking awake.
What's happening?
Where am I?
Yeah.
Where am I? Who are you people?
What? Oh.
Why am I here?
Oh, God. Is that a motorcycle?
Hmm. Okay. So. Once again. Yoink. Customers, tell them about today's special, Bucky. The guy's waiting for the monorail as well. First in, last out. First in, last out. I'm not certain what that does. I mean, what that means.
Yeah,
I'm hoping that's not an innuendo.
You know, I'm actually pretty sure that that's an, a ranger saying.
Oh, yeah, military, I believe you're right.
An army ranger saying, yeah.
I don't know what the relevance is here, though.
I don't know, do you meet the military, you guys?
You do, eventually, yeah. Pretty sure I die somewhere along the way here. Oh! That's a nice bank shot he got me with there.
I quite like non-conventional, like, firing weapons. I think they're a nice switch up from just, like, bullets.
Yeah. Well, like I said, this game doesn't have a huge number of weapons, but they're all quite distinct from each other, which is fun. And there's some pretty weird, and there's some, you know, some weird ones. Backpack is his weak spot.
I'm interested by how he just has infinite, those spike ball thingies to shoot.
Oh yeah, he's well stocked, that's for sure. He is. Ow! And my kicking skills are currently leaving something to be desired.
So if you don't blow up the backpack when you kill him, do you get more ammo out of the thing?
I don't know if that makes a difference. I would guess not, but I don't really know. I mean, it's not like he seems to be in danger of running low.
Yeah. I mean, I think that would be neat if it did.
Oh, down I go! Oh. Down I go.
But I suppose, like, that's the kind of thing that would appease me, and other people would look at it and be like, why did you spend the time to do this?
Sure.
I guess that's the difference, though. It's so much easier to just drop a full weapon. And most people who play nowadays are just like, that's fine. That's why,
But the ammunition stockpile purist holds it to a higher standard.
Well, like, I actually think of, like, Metro 2033.
Oh, yeah, well, isn't, like, ammo supply is, like, a very big concern in that game, right?
Yeah. Bullets are the same as currency, which, God help you.
Oh, that's right.
God help you in any world where bullets are the same thing as currency.
Yeah, that's... You're probably in for a rough time.
Yeah.
Probably in for a rough time.
But, yeah, like, that's the system in that game. Like, it's very...
Well, it's post-apocalyptic, right?
Yeah. I suppose it's a little bit like Fallout, but then again, like, when you get to a certain point in Fallout, you just take the ammo off people because it weighs nothing. you haven't played Fallout 3, have you?
I have not.
Yeah.
I played the first two, way back.
Ammo, in 3 anyways, ammo doesn't weigh anything. So, like, you can, like, you'll kill a guy, and you'll be like, oh, this gun's kind of crap, but I'll take the ammo. Because eventually, you stockpile so much of the ammo that when you sell it, you'll get, like, hundreds of caps.
So 3 still uses bottle caps as money?
Yeah. And you can find, like, bundles of free war money. We should do that for an LP.
That'd be cool.
I have Fallout 3.
I'd be down for that.
And then I have the 2 DLCs that I would care to actually play.
Are there others that you don't?
Yeah, there's the Mothership Zeta and the Swamp One Point Lookout or something like that. I have Operation Anchorage and Brotherhood of Broken Steel.
Is Operation Anchorage, is that the one that like takes place like before the apocalypse or something?
Yeah, and you play...
It's actually like in World War 3 or something like that?
Yep. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Who did the United States have a nuclear war with in that universe? Was it China?
China.
Okay, sorry.
It's really great.
We'd conquered Canada by that point.
Yes.
Canada. Our maple syrup stockpiles.
We needed it. We needed the maple.
All the other fuel supplies were running out.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just super funny. Anyways.
Okay. Oh!
I didn't even see you make contact with that guy.
Didn't see me what?
Make contact with him. You were just sliding and all of a sudden he was in the air.
Gray's kick is so powerful that he doesn't actually have to hit them. It's just like the... just the shock front from his boot approaching.
The air wave around him.
Is enough to, like, launch men off their feet. Oh! Nice. Detorsoed.